encompassing what it takes to be a teacher. How's it going, Mr. Bucon?
I'm doing fine, Hunter. How are you doing today?
I'm all right.
All right, great.
So let's get into our first question here. Why did you become a teacher?
Wow. That's a tough question. Only because I've been doing this for so long. You know, I've been teaching for, I think this is my 33rd year. That's a long time. That's like, how many years you've been in school? Like taking school, like you're
12 years.
You're 11th grade.
12 years.
Oh yeah, 12 years. So 12 times three is like, well, 11th grade, let's skip kindergarten. 11 times three, that's like three times as long as you've been in school.
It's a long time.
It's a long time. Yeah. So why did I become a teacher?
Yeah.
No, Hunter, it's a good question. I think, you know, what I first wanted to do, I think it's always what I wanted to do. But I think as I continue teaching, my reasons for staying in changed. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I think you start something for one reason. Like, I think going into teaching, I thought it's going to be this kind of this perfect world. Students are always going to be, like, sitting there ready to learn stuff. And then, like, reality hits you, and it's not the same. And you have to kind of adjust what's going on around you. You know what I mean? And so it's why you became, and it's why you stay a teacher. Talk to me.
I know you have a hobby outside of teaching, your podcast. Why did you think of starting that?
Well, Hunter, it was actually because former students had motivated me to do that. When I first came here to Central, I taught a student by the name of J.T. Nixon, and he and his brother and some of their friends started to put together their own podcast, and they invited me down to see it, because I started listening. That sounds really good. Are people allowed to go and watch this? So I went and I watched it, and I was like, wow, that is really cool how they do that. And I started thinking, I'd like to try this. And so that's why I did it. I just tried it, watched how they did it, and then kind of created my own style. And that's how I got started with that.
So they just intrigued you into creating your own?
Yeah, because I initially went on, they interviewed me the first time on there, and I saw how they were doing. I said, I wonder if I could do this. And so I had to think of a name, and to do this, do that, and I just came up with my own. So I had to have my own style, because I couldn't do what they were doing, because they were like high energy, talk about all kinds of stuff. They would curse once in a while, and that's just not me.
I get it. You gotta keep it family friendly.
I try to.
All right. So, what made you think of teaching English instead of another subject?
Well, it's interesting that you say that. When I went to college, I chose at several different subjects I was considering. Initially, I went because my Spanish education here at Central was so good that I went to West Liberty. This one was State College, and I went there and they said, if you've had like at least 3 years of Spanish, you can take this test and we can, like, you can skip certain levels. So I took the test and they gave me credit for, I think, two levels of Spanish. And I went into like an upper level. I was like, wow, this is great. I thought, I want to teach Spanish. So I would have been like, Senorita Ray. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But I started doing that. I got really bored with that because I just got tired of that. Is it? It just wasn't for me. And then I was taking some math classes. I thought I was really good at math. I took this one class in college called Elementary Math. It was so easy. I was like, this is really good. I was making A's. I know, I felt really good. I was like, maybe I could be a math teacher. The problem was I didn't realize it was elementary math. So it was like math that you do in elementary school. And I was like, well, and then I had to start taking harder math classes. And I said, this isn't for me. And so the teachers here at Central had no worry about me coming in and saying, hey, I'm going to teach math, because that wasn't going to happen. And then I just went into English. And then my second specialization was speech communications, or oral communications. And so all kind of worked together. And that's what I've been teaching.
So it took you a while, but you finally hit your topic of English.
Yeah, I think it takes some time in anything that you do, Hunter, to figure out like where your groove is, where you excel the most, where you are in terms of like what can I do? What can I do? What am I best at doing? And you just got to find that. And it doesn't happen overnight.
So what is your favorite thing to teach inside of English? Like which story, which topic, which era?
That's another great question. I'm kind of thinking about different things that I enjoy. Honestly, you know what? It's not necessarily the content that's enjoyable, it's the students that are there. Like, you know, I have like your brother Hayden in class and his, you know, the crew, Paxton, Hildy, and Dion, you know, and John, and they're all, you know, and the girls, and they're all great. And what's neat is, it's not so much what I'm teaching them, but it's like when students come in, I like to find things that I think will be interesting to them, or that maybe can open their eye to some different things. Like we just did, you're a baseball player, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you familiar with Lou Gehrig?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know who he played for?
The Yankees.
Yep, there you go. So anyhow, we were doing Lou Gehrig's farewell speech. We were reading that in class and analyzing some of the reasons why he gave the speech and some of the ways he tried to connect with the audience. And we had just a really good discussion about like life and death and, you know, expressing gratitude to the people, you know, that we love. And then we wrote about it. They did their own little speech on it. And it was just really cool because they kind of embraced it and enjoyed it. It was just a really good class. So I don't know if there's anything in particular other than just trying to find something kind of matches up with students. That's always the challenge.
So your aim isn't really, let's go for something we teach each year. It's more of something, let's see what fits the students.
Kind of. Like, I have certain things I do every year, okay? But then sometimes I need to try something different because that keeps it fresh for me. You know, it's like if you do the same thing over and over again, do you ever get bored with it?
Yeah, you get burnt out.
Yeah, I'm getting burnt out with it. So I have to change things up a little bit, and that's what I do. You know, that's how it goes.
Well, thank you for the interview.
Well, hey, how's school going for you?
It's going well.
If you don't mind.
No, good deal. It's going well.
All right.
Keep my grades up.
Yeah. So what class is this for? We're doing this interview.
It's for video production.
Video production. Is this your second go-round?
Second go-round, video production too.
How do you like that?
It's a great class. Mr. Morris came in last year. Great teacher.
Yes.
Always giving something out, always doing homework. Always doing work for him. He's at every event, always filming. He does NHFS. Keeps the games online.
Right.
Always has us working for him. Always has us.
Do you like being in front of the camera or behind the camera?
Say behind it.
Really? Why is that?
Yeah, it's easier to film and edit things than it is to interview.
Really?
Yeah.
It's just a difficult interview.
Not really.
Well, I think you did a great job, my man.
Thank you.
All right, thanks. You know, like Sammy Uso. All right.